I'm so glad that, because Martin would be like, you're not really being fair. Am I crazy?
No. That is the most ridiculous shit I think I've ever heard.
See, Martin likes this. He kind of enjoyed it, so he thinks I'm being harsh.
Well, you are.
But the...
Nah, you know what this sounds like? You know what that... You know what that... I'm having flashbacks. I'm shell-shocked. I'm still having flashbacks. That sounds like some Taken 3 type shit.
Don't bing, 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 bing.
No.
Luke Besson. Luke Besson gets to a certain point with his franchises where he doesn't give a fuck.
Yeah.
Do y'all, and I've had this problem for years, after you pee, do you have a problem with it just keep dribbling when you're done?
That's old.
That's old people that, shit. Yes.
What you're learning from this particular episode is that you and I are in the same box.
I'm not you.
The only difference is
I'm not you.
I'm already at a point where I'm like, yeah, they make their jokes, whatever. I don't care. You still care.
I'm like Luke Skywalker hanging on that.
No, it's not true. I'll never join you. No. I'll never join the old side. No.
Have your fun. Have your... Both you motherfuckers have your fun. I don't give a fuck. You too, Martin. But you just...
I'm having so much fun. You don't even know. You know why Martin is so cool? Because he embraces it.
It's better than the alternative.
He fights it. Motherfucker still got Chuck Taylors on.
No.
You see.
Teach you to talk about my fucking game, goddammit.
You see.
That's true. So
but he went over to Africa, paid 50 grand. They believe that he bribed somebody so that he could hunt this lion down. The lion, like I told you, was Cecil the Lion.
By the way, you cannot do that.
No, you can't.
You cannot
do that.
Do that.
You ain't got to convince me, brother. I'm not the smartest man in the world.
You can't do that, but I'm looking at it happening. I mean, I hear your words, but I'm looking at it. But I'm looking at it. My eyes are telling me something different.
I guess you think dragons exist too when you watch fucking Harry Potter and Game of Thrones and shit.
Well, those are fake.
Okay, fuck you, man. This shit right here, I've been on a jet ski.
And he's going.
That you can't even ride water like he's riding. The moment you hit land, that mother will that will flip you the fuck over
it's
doing
not a
that
moment,
shit.
I'm looking at it. It's not a moment he's looking back like, holy shit, I'm driving on land.
Yeah, man.
No.
But, like, but what the fuck?
You talking about you doing it. He's a transporter.
God damn it.
I mean, he knows vehicles. That's driving. He does that for a living.
No, that's not true.
This is why I'm so angry at this shit, because that's what they do. It's like, oh, he's a transporter. He can do any fucking thing.
Get the fuck out of here. You get the fuck out of here. No. No.
Man.
No. And no.
Oh, people.
Come on.
The motherfucking levitated. Angled his body to a fucking horizontal 90-degree angle and crashed into a front seat of a car.
Perfect.
Feet first. Did you?
With a nice pose.
And the mother... Yeah,
he posed. He did this.
He did
the lounge
what
look.
What'd he do?
Rap.
He... One more time for those who missed it. I'm going to pause it at that point.
Do it. Straight chilling. Cruising.
He lazy boyed himself.
He did. Coasting. Boom.
When did this shit turn to the Matrix? This is some JFK assassination shit.
It
you
is.
Know what I'm saying? Back into the left.
Yeah.
Back into the left. Back into the... How the fuck does that magic happen?
Come on, man. Come on, dude. When you said they stopped giving a fuck, I thought, you know, maybe they, you know, story might have dropped off to just, you know, some complication. That is absurd.
This motherfucker turned into a wizard all of a sudden.
Come on.
And then that you gonna do about it, bitch?
It is marketing.
Sitting in that bathwater getting wrinkly.
Some, you know, fuck yeah, get it. I mean, she got a makeup on. Look at this book. Like, people saying, oh, she ain't got any makeup on. No, she's got some. She got a little bit of makeup on. Hair, that was planned the way her hair is. This is like going on a photo shoot. Damn it, you celebrities. What the fuck going on? Are you in a bubble? Does money and fame make you stupid? Do you not have a clue how to talk to people?
Kill them with kindness. Okay. All right, I'm in. I'm all for it. Whatever he's selling, I'm for it.
This, we said it before, but I'm going to say it again. This motherfucker is a supervillain.
A warm place. They going to have each other. Somebody's going to have to give us some booty. And it just ain't simple.
And that's the creepiest part.
Booty was more important than food. Booty. A man's butt.
Why is he going? The important thing is the booty.
Why is he going into depth though? Like, we don't know what a booty is. Like, booty, ass,
a man butt,
a buttocks, gluteus maximus, booty for days, every day, all booty.
I like booty.
Johnson went on to tell our crew. How-
You really think it's going into a serious direction. But it does not.
You can make this shit as sinister as you want to, but I still like booty.
I like it just the same like as I did just, 5 minutes
they
ago.
Had a bet, they had to be like, look, you're going to interview. If you say booty at least 27 times.
This man will be out amongst us all here in a little bit.
So. Yes, he will.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Hide your kids, hide your ass. This shit is real.
That's real. Thank you guys for showing me that.
The more you know.
Yeah.
Thank you. Do-do,
yeah. See your ass go over your head. I didn't mean to bring everything down, people. I didn't mean to. Let's talk about something nice, like whale dick.
You know, that's whoa. I might need to go buy a gun. I'm feeling kind of inadequate now.
You have scientists out there that begin to do like these tweet-offs. Scientists are looking at so many animal dicks, they're like trading them now. Who's seen the weirdest dick? Because that is not a dick. That's an arm.
Yeah, it's like an arm with the finger extended.
Exactly.
The hand.
Exactly. You see that where that finger's coming
it's
out?
It's like E.T. giving somebody the fuck off.
Yeah. It's almost like that whale's dick is saying, I smell pussy right over there. Tally ho, let's go.
Forward.
Forward.
Starboard, 45 degrees.
Yeah. Go west, young whale, and fuck that ass. I have this thing where I'm fascinated by animal genitalia. Because I've always wondered, like, especially the animals that look like they ain't got shit down there.
Right. Particularly the mammals.
Yeah, the mammals. I remember asking my brother, it's like, you know, you always talk about the birds and the bees. Like, how do birds have sex? I know.
With
look,
bees.
Yeah. Shall bees, I don't know. Like, where does, how do birds do it? And he's like, well, shit, man, you know, birds, like anybody else, man. He sticks his dick up in the fucking bird chick, you know, in the fucking bird pussy. What you want me to say? Shit, y'all out there looking at me like I'm fucking nuts. Don't act like I'm crazy. Shit, y'all gonna be thinking about tonight. Yeah, man, where the fucking porcupine dick come from? That shit got spikes on it. I don't know.
Yeah, it's got something.
Yeah.
So, do y'all, and I've had this problem for years, after you pee, do you have a problem with it just keep dribbling when you're done?
That's old.
That's old people.
That shit, yes. What you're learning from this particular episode is that you and I are in the same box.
I'm not you.
The only difference is
I'm not you.
I'm already at a point where I'm like, yeah, they make their jokes, whatever. I don't care. You still care.
I'm like Luke Skywalker hanging on that.
No! It's not true! I'll never join you! No!
I'll never join the old side! No! Have your fun. Both you motherfuckers have your fun. I don't give a fuck. You too, Martin. But you just
having so much blast.
You don't even know. And you know why Martin is so cool? Because he embraces it.
It's better than the alternative.
He fights it. Motherfucker still got Chuck Taylors on.
No. Stop.
Teach you to talk about my fucking game, goddammit.
You see.
That's your soul.
The moment they threw that dog through that window, I knew they didn't give a shit about anything else after that. You know, a lot of times in movies, they'll kill the fuck out of human beings. They'll kill all these human beings. Like, don't kill the poor old dog. Leave the dog alone. They said, fuck that dog. And, you know, hey, man, look, I that's what I had admiration for this shit right here. That's what I said. Hey, you know what? I respect what they're doing. I get it. You don't give a fuck. I get it. And liberties.
You let me stick in the tip, so.
No. I mean, if you want to stick it all the way in, it goes out your ear or something. Yeah. We want to talk about that kind of stupid, but come on, Mom, take the shot.
What?
God damn it, take the shot! Am I lying?
No.
Welcome to Dead Storage.
Oh my God!
Hold up. I bounced out because I was like, I can't do this.
That right there, it's like, you look at this and it's like, did someone bail and they had to get a puppet? Did someone quit?
Somebody quit this part.
This is not explained. I'm telling you, there is no explanation for this.
It's like he's a placeholder for whenever they get the real dinosaur made. Yes. Yeah,
like when they have like a tennis ball where you do CG.
Yeah, yeah.
New York blew my mind. What was so great was that with Oz, because he was like, you know, hey, who's from out of town? And there was that one guy from Russia that you guys brought on stage. You were like, hey, Russia, you know,
I didn't ask for a full story.
You know,
I just wanted to. I'm trying to do a promotion. That's
like,
all.
And then Oz was like,
I just wanted him to say, man, that was amazing. That's all I was looking for.
Harlem, Brooklyn.
That's how good the show is. He can't stop talking about it.
Stop talking about it.
Listen, he can't.
It was like an Avengers Endgame.
Yeah.
This could be you. If you go to one of our shows, you see how excited people are? Adelaide Hall, May 25th. Show starts at 7. Full night of games, music, and of course, comedy. So please show up. Yeah, man. Oh, I'm glad you had a good time, dude. Man, you just made a ringing endorsement for our shows. Thank you so much.
Oh, well, Shay, you're just in luck.
So you got a bunch of men's locked up in one place. They gonna have each other. Somebody's gonna have to give us some booty. And it just ain't simple.
That's the creepiest part.
Booty was more important than food. Booty. A man's butt.
Why is he going? The important thing is the booty.
Why is he going into depth though? Like, we don't know what a booty is. Like, booty, ass,
a man butt,
a buttocks, gluteus maximus, booty for days, every day, all booty.
I like booty.
Johnson went on to tell our crew. Help.
You really think it's going into a serious direction, but it does not.
You can make this shit as sinister as you want to, but I still like booty.
I like it just the same as I did 5 minutes
ago. They had to bet it. They had to be like, look, you're going to interview. If you say booty at least 27 times.
This man will be out amongst us all here in a little bit. So.
Yes, he will.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Hide your kids, hide your ass. This shit is real. That's
real. Thank you guys for showing me that.
The more you know.
Yeah. Thank you. Do-do-do-do-do.
Yeah. See your ass go over your head. The shit,
they go overboard with
the
it.
The shit even gets crazier. If I was in the UK, I'd sue this fucking film.
Yeah,
because
exactly.
they make the UK, especially London, look like the most inept fucking city. Just plain stupid when it comes to protection. They got people. Now, they have all these foreign officials come in. Leaders and shit, and they get to the city and they just hanging out by themselves with no protection.
With no protection.
I mean, they hanging out on boats and shit. Oh,
yeah. You know, you keep showing us, they make it look like Baghdad.
Yeah, they hanging out on boats sightseeing. They got one Japanese dude. He's stuck in traffic next to like average Joe's getting off of work.
Wow, really?
I'm like, did y'all not fucking cut the traffic off for the dignitaries to come in and come through? This dude is, I mean, it's almost like he's in an Uber and shit. He's like, hey man, we gonna get there? I mean,
this car smells like weed. I'm not happy with this.
You can see somebody in a minivan with kids going to a soccer game next to the dude. It's like, wow, man. Look, he's just all chipper and shit. All fuck. Hey, you know, my girl's not going to be a pussy like you, Mr. President.
Right. You out of shape, bitch.
He just leaves him, you know, fuck you.
Yeah, he's like Captain America.
Yeah. On your left.
Say it again. Say it. Yeah. I swear to God, I'm going to kill you.
Aaron Eckhart, like, yeah, had that man killed. You know, he's like, if you'd have saved my ass so many times, I'd have you fucking fired. Sorry. maybe the movie did turn me on just a little bit. Hey, this skeleton's about as skinny as that girl in the
I'm
movie.
I'm sorry
too.
We had to have our show derailed by that sight gag.
What, no gag?
The gag is going in your mouth later.
Shit, me and that skeleton going to be looking like Bing Rames and Bruce Willis by the end of the show. And he's back there going, no, no.
Did you catch that? Did you catch that, Frederick Douglass?
They also helped fight slavery.
Yeah.
Well, they sure took the sweet ass tongue. God damn. How long is slavery last?
I think some of them were masters. That's how slavery lasted so long. Yeah. They had, how you think it lasted for 700 years? They had robots making us pick cotton. They had Frederick Douglass up here. They helped Frederick Douglass. What, comb his hair? Because they sure didn't do anything to help slavery.
You know,
and this is what I'm talking about. They had to hire Anthony Hopkins to make him get up there and try to sell that story.
And even then, it's like, shut the f*** up, Anthony.
Really? You want me to? Okay, I guess.
Yeah, all right. That's the bottom of my list right there. Like, damn, you just starting off with that?
Oh, yeah.
As you can see.
Oh, no, man.
Yeah. Yeah, even your boy. Even your boy. And like, I like when Martin's like, not him too. They didn't get you too.
Oh, man, you making money? You ain't gotta do this shit.
Not working, but you know what? She's like, ain't no way in hell I'm gonna try that. Yeah, you try to stick a dick that big in it, you'd be like this. Damn. I like the way that cat didn't even bust a nut. That cat's like, shit, I'm gone. The police get called.
I like how long it took for the orange cat to even get the hint.
I don't want to keep taking this time.
So you don't like? Okay.
I know that cat is like, shit, fuck it. Mouse. Look at that cat. Like, let me try that 50 Shades of Grey shit on me. Get the fuck out of here.
I think it just depends on if you know what you're doing.
Okay. Well, let me ask you about this.
Well, with these unfortunate people, if they do well with their tongue, is that enough?
Okay. All right. We're getting there.
This is fun. Next time.
All right, man. Goddamn.
I think I'm drunk again.
Oh, people making gay fan fiction about me and Martin.
The ears.
Complete with illustrations and shit.
Aww.
It's like looking at a black version of The Notebook right there.
I love how I'm wearing a sharecropper's hat.
It's like slave love and shit. Why'd they give me that hat, man?
I like the shading.
It's like I took it off of a mule right before I put it on.
It's funny, Martin, because it's like a slave making love to a black Vulcan. Look at you, see my ear.
Star Trek fanfic.
Have you look at my ear?
I don't know what planet you came from. Yeah. But take me, but I see the stars in your eyes.
It's like the Enterprise went back to slave times. And I found love. Yeah. Let me take you away from this cotton field. It's illogical. This is another one right here. These Photoshops are killing me. This is silly. This is just silly. They got you, Martin, as a ventriloquist, and they got Corey Goodwin as the dummy. Don't talk to me or my son ever again.
I love that face that caught Martin.
Oh, that Martin. That Martin.
Man, this is awesome.
Oh, man. Kevin King, man.
Who did this, Kevin King?
Yeah,
always.
Corey looks like Vern Troyer.
You look disturbed.
Man, that expression that got you with Corey right there.
Martin's face, man.
Both y'all, man. Man, I'm telling y'all, y'all are wild for this shit. And y'all got it. You can go to Double Toast. You ain't got to pay anything, but y'all got to go there and look at some of this fan art people do. This shit is crazy.
Oh my God.
This shit is crazy.
It gets weird.
I know you got that outfit, man. I know you do.
That Pee Wee Herman outfit.
Halloween, Martin, let's do it.
Yeah.
That's just too much.
Oh, Kevin King, you crazy for that one, man.
Goddamn, Kevin King.
But love it.
Everything. Every time I think he's reached his zenith, he finds a way to go above it.
Always. Top consistent. Top. That's why I love him.
Yeah. Every time.
Holy shit.
This comes from, I think I'm gonna say that this is Haas. It's HOS. I don't know if they meant hose, but I think it's Haas. And it says here, have you seen this video of a Burger King employee smashing their windows because of a prank. My friends sometimes talk down about people working in fast food. I try to argue this, but he says I try to argue the case where.
What is this? You want me to read it?
Sound it out, Corey.
Get us with tactics like this, man.
Exactly. Make it look easy.
Right now, there's a flea watching this shit, and he's like, damn, my dick is bigger than this cheeser right here. Now, I'm pissed. I'm not going to lie. I'm mad as fuck about this. Wait a minute, Tommy.
Wait a minute. Let me break out my magnifying
glass. Yeah, hold on, Tommy. Let me pull out my magnifying glass and let me play that game real quick. Maybe I get closer with this shit. Let me see. No, I don't see shit.
Still don't see it.
No, I don't see a goddamn thing, Tommy.
Goddamn Marvel, man.
It was owned by Disney. Now they put out a teaser trailer that is about. The size, no, small, about the size of one of my boogers from my nose. This trailer is harder to see than your black ass sitting in that room right there, that dark ass room, Tommy. You know, it's, by the way, get a light in there.
Yeah, I'll work on that. I'll work on it. Well, closer to the light.
Ant-Man is one thing, but you ain't no fucking Ant-Man. You know, I can't. I need to see you, Tommy. Marvel. That's when you know that you got power. And man, what is going on with you, man? Yeah, you might be. Hey, somebody put that dog in the refrigerator.
Just right on his neck. Just on his neck. Yeah, make a popsicle.
Yeah. Anyway, now here's the thing with you. You like the marijuana.
That's pretty cool.
Hurricane Katrina was more luxurious than this shit.
You imagine being a person who's been hired to serve that to everybody?
You just going through, you know, everything you do, you just deliver it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
No.
And we're talking about the actresses. What actress? What's her name?
Rebecca Ferguson.
Yeah. Rebecca Ferguson.
They wrote this shit. We got to hold them to task.
Yeah.
What the fuck were you thinking?
Yeah, Rebecca Ferguson, she has this idea, like, I guess she got reprimanded on her job for messing up, and she's like, well, I'm going to show them, I'm going to do some deep undercover shit, and this is like, why would you fucking do that? Look at that shit! Well, I'm going to go in and try to fuck the villain and see what that goes.
Yeah, let's see how it goes from here. It's like a Leia trying to bang Darth Vader. Yeah. That'll solve the problem. How?
And then suddenly it's like, oh, wait, the most important part of my plan is missing.
Yeah! Well, you should have kept on you.
If I just lure the villain with my vagina, but that'll solve the case. Yeah. This can't go wrong at all. I mean, and plus, I didn't tell anybody where I was.
Right. Yeah.
I left no clues, you know. Well, boy, they're gonna love this bag at the precinct.
And I left this big obvious camera right here.
Yeah. This is just a big like iPad just like on the bookcase. You'd be like, with a blinking light. What's that doing there?
Got some tape to cover it. No. But oh yeah, my thing was
the has fallen universe. This ain't no spinning off into the Nick Nolte crazy ass adventures. Ain't shit going on with this. You didn't have to do it. Y'all need to stop. If you ain't got shit to say, let people walk the fuck on and get on with their lives. And furthermore, furthermore, buddy. If you gonna do it, if you have to do it, if you positively 100% dead set on doing this, have it be something that's consistent with your movie. That shit came out of nowhere. Nobody was cracking comedy like this in the film.
Man, this shit is dumb. This shit is actually dumb. It wasted my time.
My man said humor has fallen. Thanks for watching, everybody. Love having you around. I mean, you must love being around us. You stay to the end of the video, so stick around. Hit that subscribe button. Get notifications. This makes the most dramatic exits.
That's not bad for a blind man. It ain't gonna stop no bullet!
Everybody's like, man, the door is right there.
He was upstairs. Ain't gonna stop no bullet!
Some people just jump through windows in movies. Don't get cut up.
Get cut up, but you got to admire his. He was like all about getting out of there because he jumped in mid sentence. He did. He's like, I'm gonna make him think I'm gonna finish what I'm saying.
I finished this.
Yeah, that's one of those like you'll never get me alive.
Yeah. But he was like, it ain't gonna stop no bother. Stop no fun.
He was Batman, right? But also with Slag, man. Slag is so evil that he gets that evil laugh that comes with thunder. Got echo on it, too. Man, the funny thing is, either they're really bad actors. There's some people who do some really bad death scenes in this way. You think I'm exaggerating? And by the way, the first dude that he kills is the black dude.
Did
you notice his shirt didn't even get sliced?
You're right.
Y'all thought I was playing. No, but he was waiting on it.
Remember, he was looking like Richard Pryor. Just waiting.
He was like Richard Pryor.
Before he even starts slicing, look at him in the corner. He's like.
Is he about to cough up a piece of chicken?
Look, he ate something bad.
No blood.
Oh, it's beautiful. I love it. I mean,
let die. You know in the Matrix when they get a plug? Yeah. No,
exactly
not like this. Not like this.
My man.
Oh, that was good.
Apparently my man's acting abilities died before he did.
He went to sleep.
Yeah. Like, shit, my attention span died.
He was tired. He ate too much.
Mm. He had the itis. Yeah. Diabetes, sugar rush.
The price tags of Black Friday. Yeah.
Just stand in front of this
crazy, man.
Early bird gets the what? He looked like Marlon Wayans.
Yeah. He does.
He looks like a cross between Marlon Wayans and a velociraptor right now. Look at
him. He's a human nutcracker.
Oh, man. On a commercial, man.
Jesus. Man. Jesus Christ, man.
That young man is gold.
Oh, he really is.
He's kind of gold. Say.
I know you're from another planet.
Yeah, looking like Kunta Kinte up in this shit.
He does.
Toby. You know.
LeVar Burton.
LeVar Burton looking ass and shit. You know, I'm just saying, this is the kind of motherfucker, I think he's insane. I think he's crazy. And he's one of those crazy people that's always looking for attention.
Yeah, an attention whore that's a crazy person.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Those are two bad things.
Oh, yes, it is.
If you don't pick it up quickly, I'm going to ask you to leave.
What's that?
Dan is like a fucking velociraptor.
I know.
That's not even a proper reaction to what that man just told him. What the fuck,
dude,
man?
They had to have edited that together. There's no way
that's what I was thinking.
They had to have edited that together, man. There's no way.
You don't pick it up quick. No, dude, he did that shit all the time at school, man. It's fucking ridiculous.
This motherfucker pulled a Prince on him.
I'm thinking of Alien. I think like another mouth is gonna come out and shit.
Like, you know what that reminds me of? You remember the end of Invasion of the Body Snatchers?
Yeah.
That's what that reminded me of.
Yeah, you remember at the end when you're like, if you did anything that was out of the ordinary, and the Body Snatchers knew who you were, they pulled that shit. You can be all the
players. The motherfucker points at price tags at Black Friday. Like,
about every 2 months. Like, he was quiet.
Yeah.
And he wouldn't fuck with people a whole lot, but every 2 months, it'd just be a day where he's just sitting there just like, hey, everybody! You know, Gage just had to come out.
It's a glitter bomb.
Yeah, literally, yeah. Motherfuckers exploded in sparkles and shit. And so I thought that's what this dude was like. Like, he just, yeah, just exploding gay one day. But, and the reason why I thought that he was gay, because he's on a, he, is he on like America's Most Wanted or
he didn't kill nobody, man. What the fuck?
No, I'm sorry. What is it? So, America's Got Talent?
Two different
things. No, it's Rick?
No.
Yeah.
Let me see. Check it.
No, that's too big.
I got to remove my balls if I got to do
see, that. See, you know, that is what it looks like. You look like you got two nuts coming out of your nostrils, man.
Yeah.
I gotta remove my balls.
I gotta remove.
You got lipsticles right there. You know, it's
nosticles.
Nosticles. Can you do me a favor though? Can you throw me some water? I mean, just throw it, man. Just throw it right in my mouth.
Oh, damn.
Damn. Felix, goddamn, man.
Oh,
damn. Damn. Felix, goddamn, man. No, there's no need to throw water, man. You got me last time. You almost killed me last time. But Felix, just hear me out. It's nothing against you, brother. Love you, Felix. I really do. Well, almost. It's so.
According to this book.
According to this book. And I'm going to get into that, too. Because you got to go by the book. Even then, the book is entertaining. Shit. Just I said get James Franco to play Trump. Said, why not? You know, because I even said that the Disaster Artist. The book and the movie are almost two different things.
Right.
Trucker.
No.
No armed robbers. Just look at him. Ice cream! Ice cream man! Stop! Ice cream man!
Throw down some change.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I got money! Ice cream! Stop!
We toasted on the bar.
Civil War trailer, they say, is out. An hour ago.
Thanks, Will, for letting us know.
Well, we were in the middle of doing a review. All right. Y'all want to watch the Civil War trailer?
Sure,
yeah.
I'm not really prepared for it, but we'll give a real... Where were you on the night of... Stop on that goddamn fart! You could just see Darth Vader beside that glove.
You have failed me.
Our
for
first
last
caress.
Time. You have failed me for the last time, Wendy. Get me another show host.
Shirt off. Yeah!
Instead of all that fucking noise. New script, huh?
This is Tyler Perry. Catch that motherfucker. Get the straight jacket on his ass. You know, it's Tyler Perry. Tyler Perry goes nuts. $10 million in the deed back to the house. She is not happy with that.
What?
Oh, I must say also, by the end of this movie, I heard something that I've never heard in any Tyler Perry movie at all. Black women say, what?
I thought you were going to say sense.
That's where she goes.
You ain't shit.
No, that's where she's like, he owes me half his money. Mm-hmm. I want to like get back in his life. He owes me everything. And she starts stalking them. She starts having visions of murder. Now, here's where we get to the crazy part. Now, this is the.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. We get to the crazy part.
Yeah.
That was the normal part.
There's one thing to cry about your daughter.
Sure.
And legal battles you have with it.
You can understand that.
I can understand that, but this brother made a video where he's crying about his chef. He's crying.
Wait, he's got a chef?
Oh, Martin, you mad now.
I'm mad.
Just wait.
Oh, I thought that's all he got was his daughter.
Oh, you're going to be mad in a little while when I reveal all. But, yeah, he's crying about, and after he's finished crying about his chef, for some reason he gets so happy, he starts twerking.
He cooks for us every day, and he's so fucking passionate about just feeding. He's been suffering for 5 days.
This nigga lost his mind, man.
this,
nigga gonna lost his fucking mind.
Oh my god.
He enjoys cooking. That's why he does it. Oh, you pay him, homeboy.
I'm sure you pay him very well.
He cooks for us because he loves us.
Yeah. And I like how he's like, they're all I got. I'm like, who's recording the video?
This nigga's crazy.
He losing his fucking mind, man.
Who is this video for?
Him.
Him and his crazy ass fucking mind.
All his fans.
Because,
oh shit, you're right.
Yeah.
Shut up, Corey, you do this all the time.
You do, man. You had the whole internet going, no.
Yeah, you do this. Corey will argue your ass about anything.
I think it's got contrary.
Yeah. No, Clubbing Mustard, he cool, man. He cool. I vouch for him.
I just hate TJ Miller that much.
So does Cloverfield Mustard. I remember the scene scared the chef. Fuck your camera.
He's like, hey man, you know I'm just playing.
Yeah. Say cheese.
me and you, we gonna make money off this.
Yeah. Yeah, world star. Yeah.
That's the world's worst sex tape right there. Shit to my ass. let's see here. Cloverfield Mustard, bro. Kim Kardashian, man. A goddamn thing. When they say that, that's just a way for them to keep that title in there to get y'all in the mood. That Cloverfield monster that y'all looking for, he ain't there. I'm telling you this right now so that you won't be sitting up there for the whole movie being distracted from what's going on. Like, well, where he at, man? Oh, I see him. Oh, that ain't him, man. That's a shadow. You know, he ain't there. So why you sitting up there at that dinner table with flowers in your hand, waiting for him to show up? He texted me. He ain't coming. You got stood up. We all been stood up on Cloverfield Monster.
Well, to be fair, he looked in the window and he saw you first.
Yeah. Shit. She looked better on Facebook.
I'm deleting this app.
Yeah. Man, I'm glad he got rid of that helmet. Because this motherfucker looked like a Negro that just got out of jail. Where did somebody say?
Does.
Lomax. Lomax. Yeah. This motherfucker looked like he just got out and ready to go back in for whooping somebody's ass.
The Marvel Universe's Debo.
Oh, man. He looked.
Hydra Infinity Stones. I'm just going to tuck mine in.
He's one step ahead of me, man. And he looked like one big ass purple Debo right there. If you put Debo in a plaid shirt right there, you put that on. In the player shirt, he looked just like Debo.
My Stone Punk.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what he was doing to Vision.
My mama gave me that Infinity Stone. Wrecked in 2.5 minutes.
Justice League, pick your hands back up. I can't.
Just kicking you while you're down. I hate to be hard on you like that.
Throw in the damn towel.
I hate to do you like that, DC, but you gotta learn the hard way. Get your shit together. Please. And by the way, ooh, if you got to clean yourself off like I do right now, I'm doing it with a nice shirt from DT Merch. So please go to DTMerch.com and get yourself a shirt like this. Got a 20% off sale going on to December 3rd. Oh, y'all might even give you this Sullied shirt right here.
Perhaps this might clarify it better. He is retarded.
What the fuck?
You can't say that.
And it's some country shit. So this was a long term thing. Like, he was married for about 30 years and had a mistress for about 20.
Right.
So they were both in his life pretty, pretty heavily. So the day came where, they both had to pay their respects and they both kind of met up at the casket at the same time. And they got into a fight in front of the casket, knocked the casket over. The casket fell.
Oh,
half the body fell out.
Hey,
for some reason, the organ just went, yeah! I don't know why.
You start playing the Entertainer.
That's not going to distract anybody from this. It was pandemonium. Then everybody rushing to the front to try to pull people off. And the mortician trying to get the body back in quickly. That's not going to happen because caskets are heavy.
Right.
So it took about a good 5 minutes for them to get him back. And even when they got him back in, he was kind of crooked.
Oh, no.
Look, funerals at that age already kind of freaked me out. So a dead body.
And you need to watch where you are because I feel like you could attract danger to you. I think in your early 40s, early mid 40s, you'll be protected. You know, be like I said, the escalator. I don't know, 10, 15 years ago, I could have said, man, I was going to have to do this project, but I don't think you're smart or talented enough. I think I'm going to have to get somebody else. That would have just chapped your buns.
Oh, I thought you were just telling me that right now.
No.
You son of a bitch.
No. There you go. Exactly what I would expect. But yeah, it was really funny if somebody improved.
You're aggressive, Negro.
And I'm like, I'm gonna kill this motherfucker.
You're a natural athlete, but nowadays you're not.
Oh no! Oh no!
Look at me, even I'm like, what?
You've been a ruler in another lifetime, if that's true, you know, if what I'm saying is possible, and you did a good job.
Is there a possibility in one of my lives in the past I was maybe a bum or an asshole more than I am right now?
Well, what I'm seeing is that.
Hey man, thank you. That's the question I always want people to ask, and nobody has.
Have you ever had it?
Here to announce the.
The new motherfucker. So how was your speech? Tasted like lemon meringue, goddamn pie. What the fuck you think? Oh, man. Man, I feel bad for the guy because it really was. What?
No, you don't. You don't.
I really don't. He's fine.
It's easy to get a pie in and smash somebody in the face normally.
Yeah.
Because you'd have to creep up there and people would be like, hey, what's going on? But yeah. He's wearing a suit. He looks official.
He's on a stage.
Yeah. Like, like, listen to this. He's like, yeah, you. He's like, you gonna eat this motherfucker?
Yeah.
This just ain't a pie to your face. This is a fucking dessert, bitch.
Muffled him with it.
He's trying to talk.
Man, it's got all the classic Three Stooges elements to it. It's stuffed in his face. You can see pieces of the back of it falling down. Yeah. It's on his glasses. So, take them off.
So he takes it off. He's got those two clean eyes right there. Oh, this motherfucker right here, man. I love it. And he's mad. Fucking hack.
Martin, you better be careful. Someone might pull this on.
Yeah, Martin, this is going to be you one day. Martin loves pies, man, in the face. I want one of y'all to get his ass at the anniversary party.
You bet not.
Martin be talking about fucking hack.
Yeah.
Ooh-wee.
What up with that?
Man, I didn't want to say nothing until it happened. I didn't. You know what? I sat here and the charges. I sat here and I was cool and I said I don't want to be that guy. We talked about it on Monday. And I said I kept saying if it is weird, it is odd, don't add up, but we don't know,
right?
If
maybe
and no, you know, I want to get to that as short as possible. Not maybe, if he did it. You know, we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Today, I can actually, at least right now, I knew that motherfucker was guilty. I've been waiting on this. I feel so free. Boy, it is hard trying to be fair. I know you said you thought something was fishy.
I did. I thought it was just too much.
But I
sprayed them with disinfectant spray. Oh.
People, you remember how kids just used to not want to gate in their kids?
Spray this like a car.
Okay. Look at her face. And people look at her, like, be like,
they gonna throw her ass out the window.
Go.
Yeah. No.
Okay, it's a late night.
Mia just
get out of the picture.
Yeah, so no, she's no. Okay, hold on. She's gonna come back. So this is the late night. I'm setting the scene here. It's a late night, right? A dude just came over. Mia, she slid into the DM, or did you slide into his DMs? What do you want? Mia slid into his DMs. She got the guy that she wanted, but he didn't please her in bed. Now, Mia Khalifa set in the scene. I'm gonna even cross over. What was that? What was that? No. And
oh my god.
Are y'all faking together? Chase is like, all right, I'm gone. I'll see you later.
Louis, let's just say that, yeah, very bad performances from me and I.
This is amazing. Danielle's position. Oh my god. That was hot, I guess. This was that was awesome. And now we know why she quit. It's the
in his face.
To announce the
the heck. There he goes.
Martin loves the pause.
Everybody know that's Martin's thing. The pause to the face.
That is Martin's Achilles heel.
That's Three Stooges comedy. Martin every time.
Oh, and Martin, listen to it. You got to listen to what he says. Martin, listen. Just be quiet. Listen to what he says after he gets hit in the face.
Here to announce the.
Somebody laughed.
Yeah. No, listen. Listen to what he says. Because he tried. The dude is so mad. Like, he can't contain himself.
Get the heck.
He's talking about fucking heck.
He is like in Australia.
He tried to make it family friendly. He just couldn't contain himself. Fucking heck. He threw one kid friendly word in there, and the mother of all curse words, fucking heck.
He didn't even realize he said fucking heck.
He don't even realize it. Fucking
sir,
heck.
Sir, what? I call him a heck. not quite.
You fudging piece of shit. No, fuck. I mean,
somebody
heck.
Get that close to him.
That was a smooth maneuver that guy did.
Exactly.
That was what's so good about it. It doesn't make eye contact or anything. Just like,
like security is watching. It's like he's going by with a pie. I guess he should be here.
Present him with a pie. Oh dear.
Yeah. Just so you know, your mind.
I love it. He smashed it with the pie and then put his hands on his shoulders. Like,
yeah,
it's gonna be all right. And walked on.
Look at him. Yeah, he did put his hand on his shoulder. Like, good speech, by the way. If you could deliver it, boom. Yeah. He's frowning like crazy. Look at that intense frown he's got. That's the thing about it, man. This is not a joke.
That's that look when somebody is getting off the bus and they slap you real hard and then take off running.
And then there's a pie next to him.
Happy eating.
You know, because I'm looking at the dude. Maybe he was so serious that people actually thought he was serving pies.
Wait. Run it one more time.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus, Martin. This man's suffering from pie. You know,
this is really funny. It's funny because the guy's so serious that people probably thought he really was a waiter there.
Yeah. Here to announce the...
Fuck you, bitch.
Through attendance attitude, so she asked for a name to report her to corporate. Seymour says she and her kids then got doused with soda.
Oh wow!
They are using food as weapons.
Oh wow!
That sounds like the Wendy's up here.
Yeah, it does.
We got an old gangster ass Wendy's over here.
Yeah.
You want my name? It's root beer. Yeah. Ah, my
Phantom
eyes.
Bitch.
Using
boys are fighting back.
They're fighting, but using the food as weapons, man. It's getting fucking crazy.
Next thing, the manager knew they were inside with not a complaint, but a taser.
What the fuck, man?
This is over shitty food.
It is. Were nuggets involved? Because motherfuckers go crazy over some nuggets.
They lose their shit.
They do.
You don't get your sauce.
If you don't get you don't get the right sauce.
Yeah, the right sauce.
Exactly. I ask for honey mustard, bitch.
Don't ask for barbecue and get ranch.
Yeah.
So it's going to be some shit.
It's on. Dumbass people have self-entitlement. Like, I'll give you $100 for that thing. I'm about to get paid anyway. You know, she was thinking that McDonald's coffee shit.
Yeah, but that she took it to a whole nother level.
Yeah. And it was proved.
Remember mint.
Yeah.
And it was proved that it was not, I don't know how they did it, you know, but they brought forensics in over some chili.
I can go to Wendy's with an agenda.
Of all places.
No, right? Did it. Only at Wendy's.
No shit.
Only at Wendy's. How could it get crazier than that? What can you do to top that?
Somebody said, well, let me try.
Let me try. Now you got people trying to pay for their food with reptiles.
Well, that is an alligator inside a Wendy's in Royal Palm Beach. It got there, yes, after a man threw it into a drive-thru window.
The man is now in jail. It is a story you'll see only on 5.
News Channel 5's Tori Dunnan is live along Southern Boulevard where this happened. Tori?
She waiting for her order?
Go.
Go. You can tell this dude has worked with this chick for the longest time. Can't put me out here with this dumb brody. Go. When the red light blinks, that means speak.
This is one of those stories that only happens in Florida. Officials at FWC say that a man was coming up to the drive-thru here at this Wendy's. He got to the drive-thru window here. That's when he was handed a drink. When the server turned her back, officials say he grabbed a 3.5-foot gator from the back of the truck and literally tossed it through the window here.
you know what? You got to give him credit on his alligator tossing skills.
Yeah.
Like he spiraled a fucking alligator.
I mean, because you got to get that alligator through that little, window.
I mean, 3 foot, that's big. And it's moving around and it's heavy.
Maybe the alligator was sedated or drunk or something. You know, who knows, man?
It's Florida. That alligator could be on anything.
Yeah. Man, have y'all heard this story? Because, Martin, I know you've heard of this because it's all on Facebook. And I'm going to tell you right now.
I'm not the king of Facebook.
Well, it's on there, Martin. You on Facebook, too. Okay, Martin. Let me just ask you this.
Okay.
I don't want you to take it as me making fun of you for Facebook and YouTube, man. Mm. But have you noticed the amount of fake news that is going up on Facebook?
The Onion was so popular, and now you got The Current. And I know that like the Daily Current is a big one, and it's sites like that that aren't even like the Onion, where they make it obvious that it's fake.
But they're just trolling people.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Like I get fake news sent to me every day, and I spend a lot of my. That's why I don't want to go on Facebook too, because immediately when I get on there, I'm like, hey man, ain't this fun? I'm like, it's not fucking real.
Yeah,
it's, you know,
the freaking alligator I have ever seen.
Is that Optimus Prime?
The Energon.
Get it from him. The alligator turns into a Decepticon.
Is it Beast Wars?
Yeah.
Jesus, they must be 15 feet long.
Oh, he's just that terrified. He's whispering real low, trying to.
I don't know, man. You could do this in After Effects easily.
You gotta be kidding me.
Well, you ever seen anything that big?
No, never.
I think that's two guys in an alligator suit.
Yeah. Like those people in the horse costumes.
Uh-huh. Well, look how long the legs are.
Man, look at it.
Dinosaur.
Look at this shit right here,
it's a
man.
Small Godzilla.
Yeah, and that's what they say. They say that this is what makes me think that is not real, because they have this, they reported this everywhere. I was looking in The Guardian today, and they're talking about the golf course knows about him. And they go, yeah, that's Fred.
What?
So he just walks around.
Shit. You would have signs everywhere.
Get next to it for perspective.
Man, I'm telling y'all, news stories are picking this up. I'm not buying this, because they're treating him like he's like he's at a cat, like a stray cat at a restaurant.
Yeah. You know, see, the thing is, if that's your golf course, and you aren't warning people or getting rid of Fred, and he bit, let alone ate some.
The little girl. Yeah. Yoink.
Oh, man.
That's it. Talking about fucking, ain't fucking with these crumbs. Shit, you better give me a heart in me. I'm like, girl.
Damn.
Oh, my God.
And they got out.
Oh. Rob, you know what, man? Rob on that dad who wasted not even a half second before he dove in there.
Oh, man, let me tell
it's
you something.
It's not like Harambe where it's like, oh, my baby. Can somebody get my baby?
Oh, no, man. And that you said dad. No, man, that's grandpa.
Oh, really?
Grandpa jumped in there quick.
Oh, my God.
Hipster grandpa jumped in there quick.
Damn.
And got her out.
What if the dad was there? He's like, man, they ain't gonna put this on me.
No, hell
this
no.
This little girl gets eaten on my...
The pipes are caught. Oh, Jesus, fuck!
I know. I love it. Marvin's up here, man. What kind of kiddie bullshit is this?
Well, I was thinking how terrible the animation is, but that's funny.
No, man, this shit is. When I first saw this, I was like, you, what kind of bullshit? Oh, my fucking God.
You mean
I was like, he's like, Jesus fuck. I was like, I ain't never felt so horrified for a fucking potato, man. I had fries today, and I was like, this shit is fucked.
You maniac.
Yeah, this shit, it really did fuck me up, man. I don't handle shit like this. And I was like, holy shit.
And watch it drunk, too, because it'll you'll start to see other things that apparently aren't there. See dwarves walking around and everything.
You sure did. Yeah, you saw midgets and shit that weren't there. I'm not even lying, man. This movie, he might as well have been drinking this movie, man.
I was there.
Because there he's like, man, there's a midget over there. Look at it. We were like, what are you talking about? Some midget's
right like, there. Don't you see
it? She's doing what teenagers do.
Absolutely.
Except, you know, Pop still is in the White House. maybe she should have thought about that.
Oh.
That's Obama screaming.
God damn it, we almost made it out.
He's like, 3 more months. God damn, girl.
You could have kept your dress down for 3 months.
3 more months. That's all you. Girl, yeah. You couldn't wait three right. more.
I know he snatched her ass up.
Girl, what the hell is wrong with you?
That's when he got black on. Get your ass in here. God damn it.
Get your black ass in the White House.
What the motherfucker? You fucking with my career now, girl.
Like he's walking up, taking his belt off at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah, man. You know, that's all I'm saying. Pops is still in the White House. She probably could have waited, but you know, she's.
I think they're over it by now.
They are.
Yeah, they are.
You didn't like, I'm gay. You're like, I don't know what better to tell you. I'm gay. Why is this so hard for everybody?
Right?
Why am I the only normal one on this train right here? Can't you see? He's going so hard that I believe him.
Yeah.
You know, I think the dude is gay.
And he deserves to fuck that guy.
Yeah. It's like his gay spidey sense is gone. Something's driving this motherfucker crazy. It's like the sixth sense of gay. He's like, you, I see, nobody sees it, he's gay.
You mean like a gaydar?
Yeah, he's gay. Like he has excellent gaydar.
Yeah, he got spidey sense, his asshole's tingling.
It was worse earlier today when in the car. He's like, yeah, his dingleberries are going off and shit. You said this. It's just like a plastic wig. Yeah.
Come on, learn man.
Man, he's like,
man, it was all he could do. It was all he could do to not say, nigga, please.
Nigga, please. Man, he was rapping like this. Like, I give up. Fuck professionalism. Nigga, please.
Yeah, he cuts it off there. He's like, I'm done. I have nothing else.
Shit, that hood came out real quick.
So he leading? So he's leading?
He's like, man, come on. God, he started to say, God damn, brother. Well, Greg, I hope he learned a lesson right there. You know what Greg looked like a little bit, because I was looking at him. He looked like an old Joe Jackson. he looks like that now that he lost all that money. Up until then, man, right now, that's where this movie starts to really bust at the seams here. This movie starts to, y'all, no, shut the fuck up. Y'all know I didn't mean anything.
Shut up, nothing. You did that shit on purpose.
No, I didn't do it. I didn't. Did they get it? But you say, busted makes me feel good. But if I, what the hell are you doing over there? Busted up this fucking studio is what you're doing.
We'll try to move like he ain't do nothing.
I know.
It's like a cat that slips off of a stool.
Yeah. Did you see him cross his legs and everything? Like, oh, what was that?
Do continue, sir.
I must have been a ghost. I don't know. So you, man. But at that point, the more this movie starts to be a blockbuster where they start to bring
any of it.
Oh no, I watched that thinking it was the other one. I was like, oh, we're about to see some. Wow, they fucked me over.
No, they got to do shit that they couldn't do in the live action one, but it was still a piece of shit. Mm-hmm. It was bad. It was really bad. Just a little bit of nostalgia for you folks out there. So here's y'all talking about, man, they changing my Ghostbusters.
It wasn't your Ghostbusters.
Martin been over here crying for months. He's like, well, where's my gorilla at? Martin.
It wasn't named Tracy?
Yeah.
Where's Tracy? Yeah, when Leslie Jones showed up, I thought, oh, they're doing my Ghostbusters.
Oh, no.
Oh, come on. You were going to say it if I didn't.
I was not ever going to say that, Martin. I was never going to say that shit. Excuse my racist friend, my self-hating black friend over here, who can't tell the difference between a monkey suit and a lovely lady. But Martin, like,
what'd you just throw it on?
Martin, like, ain't that 2016 right there? Martin, you shame. You are a shame, Martin. And you know what? In second thought, fuck Martin. Don't you give him that gorilla. And so this shit, come then. You know.
And that's a five-star restaurant.
Yeah, no, man.
It's a five-star restaurant. Yeah.
But they are smart motherfuckers. They know what they're doing.
Yeah.
And to be fair, there's a massage parlor in the back.
Yeah, probably so.
Yeah, happy ending.
Yeah, it's probably a place. I mean, probably granted, you know, maybe that's a secret code to let people know there's a gay orgy going on in there or something, but come then. Here's the other one, right? But what gets me is that they, you know, the names they have, yeah. We said that whole, look at this, Chew Cock Long. That motherfucker knows, man.
Real talk, yeah. I was on the highway in Houston, also in Houston, Hung Dong Market. Hung Dong. Google image that shit. Hung Dong Market. Real talk.
Y'all can name restaurants Fat Cock.
And it's perfectly fine.
And it's perfectly fine. Looking at that, that's from the most like racist. That's the most racist website, English.com.
Oh my God, really? Ever.
But what gets me is that they can offend their customers and just claim, oh, I'm just Asian. I didn't know. Look, like you come here at their place, you giving them your business, and they calling you a fat fuck.
No
armed robbers. Just look at him. Ice cream! Ice cream man! Stop! Ice cream man!
Throw down some change.
Yeah, yeah. I got money! Ice cream! Stop!
We toasted on the bar.
This makes the most dramatic exits.
That's not bad for a blind man. It ain't gonna stop no bullet!
Everybody's like, man, the door is right there.
He was upstairs. He goes, no, no bullet. I hope people just jump through windows in movies. Don't get cut up.
But you got to admire his. He was like all about getting out of there because he jumped in mid-sentence. He's like, I'm going to make him think I'm going to finish what I'm saying.
Yeah, I finished this.
Yeah. Yeah. That's one of those like, you'll never get me alive.
Yeah, yeah. But he was like, it ain't goes down no bullet. Down no bullet.
No. He was Batman, right? But also with Slag, man. Slag is so evil that he gets that evil laugh that comes with thunder. Got echo on it too. Man, the funny thing is, Hurricane Katrina was more luxurious than this shit.
You imagine being a person who's been hired to serve that? It's everybody.
You just going through, you know, everything you do, you just deliver it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. So, Corey, I hear you're a pothead. And you know what? Here's the thing, Corey.
That's a great segue.
Where'd you hear that? From his own lips?
Yeah, when he said to me, so, no, man, I want to tell you something because a lot of people, they don't understand, man. What is going on with you, man?
I love the hug.
Yeah, you might be. Somebody put that dog in the refrigerator.
No, just right on his neck. Just on his neck.
Yeah, make a popsicle.
Yeah. Anyway, now here's the thing with you. You like the marijuana.
That's pretty cool.
It's called the Has Fallen universe. This ain't no spinning off into the Nick Nolte crazy-ass adventures. Ain't shit going on with this. You didn't have to do it. Y'all need to stop. If you ain't got shit to say, let people walk the on and get on with their lives. And furthermore,
hey.
Furthermore, buddy, if you're going to do it, if you have to do it, if you positively 100% set, dead set on doing this, have it be something that's consistent with your movie. That shit came out of nowhere. Nobody was cracking comedy like this in the film.
Man, this shit is dumb. This shit is actually dumb. It wasted my time.
My man said humor has fallen. Thanks for watching, everybody. Love having
Jesus
you around.
Jesus would want?
Kill them with kindness.
Okay. All right, I'm in. I'm all for it. Whatever he's selling, I'm for it.
This, we said it before, but I'm going to say it again. This motherfucker is a supervillain. He's letting us know. When he, at the end, did you hear that ominous ass music?
Yes.
Did you hear?
How could we not?
Did you hear that? Did you see how he turned around and not just poked at the, but he stabbed at that fire.
I'll show you fire.
He's like, that's him saying, I'm going to come after all you motherfuckers out there.
It is.
Hey.
Get your ass off me. The moment they threw that dog to that window, I knew they didn't give a shit about anything else after that. You know, a lot of times in movies, they'll kill the fuck out of human beings. They'll kill all these human beings. Like, but don't kill the poor old dog. Leave the dog alone. They said, fuck that dog. And you know, I that's what I had admiration for this shit right here. That's what I said. Hey, you know what? I respect what they're doing. I get it. You don't give a fuck. I get it. And for
you know what? That's the thing, because even with Daredevil, the Punisher, he's a hardcore dude, mass murder.
I think I'm gonna say that this is Hoss. It's HOS. I don't know if they meant hose, but I think it's Hoss. And it says here, have you seen this video of a Burger King employee smashing their windows because of a prank? My friends sometimes talk down about people working in fast food. I try to argue this, but he says, I try to argue the case where...
What is this? You want me to read it?
No. Sound it out, Corey.
It's because people's writing is fucked up.
It's people's writing. I don't have time to go in and phrase it the right way. Let me take a good look at this and try this again. I try to argue, but this is one case where I can't because this doesn't look like common sense to me. Do you think this says something about the intelligence of people who work in fast food? Now, here's the story. Have any of you heard about this?
Well, yeah, you sent the email, and I actually did read it, Ray, so yes, I have.
Thank you.
No, I'm not thinking about it at all.
All right.
You wouldn't I'm be probably like, getting well, too scientific let's just about
see.
This.
Let's just... No, okay. We have a safe word in case it's not working. But
you know what? She's like, ain't no way in hell I'm going to try that. Yeah, you try to stick a dick that big in it, you'd be like this. Damn. I like the way that cat didn't even bust a nut. That cat's like, shit, I'm gone. The police get called.
I like how long it took for the orange cat to even get the hint.
I don't want to keep taking this time.
Right. So you don't like? Okay,
I know a cat is like, fuck, mouse. Look at that cat. Let me try that 50 Shades of Grey shit on me. Get the fuck out of here.
A warm place. They gonna have each other. Somebody's gonna have to give us some booty, and it just ain't simple.
That's the creepiest part.
Booty was more important than food. Booty, a man's butt.
The important thing is the booty.
Why is he going into depth though? Like, we don't know what a booty is. Like, booty, ass,
a man butt,
a buttocks, gluteus maximus, booty for days, every day, all booty.
I like booty.
Johnson went on to tell our crew.
You really think it's going into a serious direction, but it does not.
You can make this shit as sinister as you want to, but I still like booty.
I like it just the same as I did 5 minutes
ago.
They
had to bet it. They had to be like, look, during an interview, if you say booty at least 27 times.
This man will be out amongst us all here in a little bit. So.
Yes, he will.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Hide your kids, hide your ass. This shit is real.
As
oh, thank you guys for showing me that.
The more you know.
Yeah. Thank you.
Do-do, yeah. See your ass go over your head. I didn't mean to bring everything down, people. I didn't mean to. Let's talk about something nice, like whale dick.
You know, that's, whoa.
I might need to go buy a gun. I'm feeling kind of inadequate now.
You have scientists out there that begin to do like these tweet-offs. Scientists are looking at so many animal dicks, they're like trading them now. Who's seen the weirdest dick? Because that is not a dick. That's an arm.
Yeah, it's like an arm with the finger extended.
Exactly.
The hand.
Exactly. You see that where that finger's coming out?
It's like E.T. giving somebody the fuck off.
Yeah. It's almost like that whale's dick is saying, I smell pussy right over there. Tally ho, let's go.
Forward.
Forward.
Starboard 45 degrees.
Yeah. Go west, young whale, and fuck that ass. I have this thing where I'm fascinated by animal genitalia. Because I've always wondered, like, especially the animals that look like they ain't got shit down there.
Right. Particularly the mammals.
Yeah, the mammals. I remember asking my brother, it's like, you know, you always talk about the birds and the bees. Like, how do birds have sex? I know.
With
look,
bees.
Yeah. So bees, I don't know. Like, where does, how do birds do it? And he's like, well, shit, man, you know, birds, like anybody else, man. He sticks his dick up in the fucking bird chick, you know, in the fucking bird pussy. What you want me to say? Shit, y'all out there looking at me like I'm fucking nuts. Don't act like I'm crazy. Shit, y'all gonna be thinking about tonight. Yeah, man, where did the fucking porcupine dick come from? That shit got spikes on it? I don't know. So, this building was...
Welcome to Dead Storage.
Oh, my God.
Hold up. I bounced out because I was like, I can't do this.
That right there, it's like, you look at this and it's like, did someone bail and they had to get a puppet? Did someone quit?
Somebody quit this part.
This is not explained. I'm telling you, there is no explanation for this.
It's like he's a placeholder for whenever they get the real dinosaur. Yes.
Yeah, like when they have like a tennis ball. Where you do...
site. We have a lot of young people on this site. A lot of young people say, I've listened to you since I was a child. I listen to you today. Some people even come in and say, you're like a brother. You're like a father to me. You know, you've been there when I never had anybody there for me. So now, you know, I'm reaching out to a lot of young people out there. And, you know, why don't y'all be there for us for a change? You know, why don't you, you're too young to be as stupid as we are. You know, you're too young to be as dumb as some of the older people out there who are messing things up. You know, for a change, just for one time. You know, you're supposed to be smarter than with all the technology we have, all the advances that we have. You're supposed to be smarter than, you know, than any generation that come before us.
It's,
you know, once you act like it.
It doesn't seem like it, but it is getting better.
Yeah, man. You know, the hell is going
what
on?
What the? Oh.
Is Denise wearing that?
Yes, she is.
Man, she's gonna fall over her
I
ass.
I know. No shoes.
Look like she's wobbling and shit. Like a... Catch her ass, but she runs into this table over here and destroys everything. It's like a bull in a china shop.
Yeah, put her in a Pokeball.
Hey, knock her ass over and see if she can get back up. Do it like a piñata. Get him!
Make sure she doesn't fall.
Oh, did she fill up?
Sarah's like, no, quit playing for real.
She fell on her ass. Fell right. I looked on her feet with dangling. Hey, everyone. Thanks for watching. And be sure to subscribe to our channel and go over to our home, doubletoasted.com, for more videos and live streams. And remember, stay toasty. See, that's how you do a prank, man. This is from TJ. TJ sent me an email that said, hey, what's good, Corey? Just needed you to possibly bring up the trailer for the Cosby parody porn. And the Cosby parody porn is called Putting My Dick Where It Don't Belong.
I've seen this.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Mr. Cosby, there are all sorts of lurid actions.
Just the faces he's making.
Hey, look. This shit is wrong. All right, I'm going to tell you, this shit ain't right. It ain't right. No, but this motherfucker does one hell of a Cosby impression, man.
These bitches, I mean, fine ladies, totally remember the fact that they were all amped up on drugs.
You drugged them.
The only thing I slipped them was my Johnson.
You know what?
He does a spot on Bill Cosby.
I mean, he looks so much like him.
He'll turn over a
certain angle. And my brain has to go like, that's not him.
Are you sure? When somebody said Cosby porn parody and they sent me that, I saw a thumbnail of this Negro right here, and I thought Cosby was really in it. In fact, I'll even go as far as to say Cosby might be innocent. He might have been framed by this dude.
Man!
That's
Bill
Cosby.
Man, that's what I saw. Look at that shit.
I loves me some white pussy. Oh.
Man.